Good evening, YouTube. So I wanted to try this EnerWave smart meter receptacle out here. So I've got my variable power supply set to about 120 volts. And if I plug that in, looks like the power goes up about a half a watt from 0.6 up to 1.1 there, and about 10 milliamps. So apparently that's the standby current and power that unit takes. I don't know if you can see, there's a light blue flashing LED, which I imagine is the device saying that it's not paired, because I haven't paired it with my controller yet. That would probably be the next step. So let's go see if this device shows up on my home automation controller. Okay, here we go. I've downloaded the online installation instructions. That's how I've wired it up. I just have the neutral, hot, and ground wire. And then over here, you've got the program button and the blue LED indicator that was flashing. So that's apparently the pairing button. Let's switch over to my home automation control window, and we'll take a look at that. Okay, so here we are on my Vera home automation control screen. This is the devices screen, and we go over here. We want to add a device, and let's see. I looked through here. I didn't see any exact listings for the EnerWave, so what we'll do is there's other Z-Wave device. Let's try that. So first you'll need to add this device to your system, so we click Next. So we have the device assembled and powered. So I'm going to go push the button on the outlet. So let's see what happens here. The blue LED went out. That didn't seem to work that time. Let me try something else here. Okay, so this is the section that talks about learning mode, adding and deleting. It says when the controller is in inclusion mode and the blue LED blinks, press the program button and then the controller will verify the inclusion. I've cycled the power, so I've got a blue flashing LED. It may be that this is already in inclusion mode, so let me go back to the Vera screen and we'll check that out. Okay, we're going to try this again here. So I'll just do a retry. Try adding again. I've got the flashing blue LED. I'm going to try pushing the button again. Maybe I'll hold it down. Ah, okay. That was the trick. You have to hold the button down for a period of time until that countdown timer goes away. Okay, so I'm planning to use this to control and monitor power going to my refrigerator. So I'll name this device refrigerator. I'll assign the room later. So we'll click Finish. Okay, it looks like we added the device. Why don't we actually take a look in here? And then here's the information. So it shows up as a binary light. So it's just on off. Okay, and then I was going to look down here. Let's try device options. So they don't have any of these predefined variables here. So one thing I like to do is put these parameters in. So we have, what is there? 1, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so I've just added the configuration settings and I've chosen to monitor only. That way we can see what the values are. So I'll do save changes. It says data saved. I probably have to go back here and go to commands. And let's do a poll now. We'll look at device options. Oh, okay, there we go. So you just have to poll the device once. Let's see if the information is correct here. So we have 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, and 10. Those are our defaults. And here's default 0, 0, 0, 1, and 10. I think what I'll do is I'm going to plug a light bulb into the outlet and we'll see if we can pick up the energy. Okay, took a little bit to get the light bulb. The light bulb socket I have is just two prong, and apparently the tamper resistant outlet needs to see the ground plug as well. So I'm going to turn the switch on, and it's a 75 watt light bulb is what I plugged in. Let me try a smaller bulb here. I'll try a 10 watt LED. Okay, here we go. I plugged in approximately a 10 watt LED. Okay, 10.5 watts. Actually, I think that's the rated power on the LED. I think it's 10.5 watts. The reason I wanted to test this here is because if I install it for my refrigerator, the outlet is buried behind the refrigerator and you can't really see anything because the refrigerator is in the way. So I wanted to test it and configure it here, and then I can take it out of my little test box and put it in the wall. Yeah, I just wanted to show you real quick here. That's the power while the unit is off. And then if we turn it on, you can see the power jumps up here roughly 1 watt when it's on, about half a watt when it's off. Turn it off here. You can see it drops back down to 1.1. And again, the no load power is about 0.6. So I've got a small candelabra bulb there. On button. And you can see it turns on pretty much instantly. And now it jumps up to 4 watts. It was 1.5 without the light bulb. So that light bulb is about 2.5 watts according to this meter. And this meter is reading actually 2.5 watts as well. So that's pretty close. Seems to respond quite quickly. Here's on and off, on, off. So yeah, I think that works pretty well. So again, this is the EnerWave ZW20RM. Duplex tamper resistant outlet, and it's got the one Z-wave controlled outlet and then one constant on outlet. And I think that's a pretty nice unit. So it monitors the power going out of this outlet. This one is operated independently, and I think this is the first time I've seen a 20 amp outlet and then also with the tamper resistant. So that's kind of a nice combination. If you're having to upgrade some outlets, and you especially if you need 20 amp and tamper resistant, this would be a good option. Gives you one remote control outlet and then one that you can just plug any old device into. If anyone has any questions about this, post that up in the comments section below. If you found this video interesting or informative, you know, give it a thumbs up. And I'll put any upcoming videos, I'll put a link to those in the upper right corner. So you can check those out. Subscribe to the channel for updates. And as always, thanks for watching.